Well, I'm going to begin by asking, I mean, one of my favourite aspects of Black Sea is how we see how kind of an impending danger affects the kind of the human psyche, how we kind of as a race kind of respond to that kind of sort of looming threat. Was that something that attracted you to this role?
Absolutely. I liked the essential kind of quality of the story, the adventure, was this willingness to face danger simply because of your desperate scenario. I mean, so they're desperate men willing to take a desperate leap in order to gain something. And what you can't underestimate is that the environment is so cynical that any false move leads to death. So your stakes as a storyteller are already really high, and then it's a case of maintaining that. So in the hands of the wonderful and incredibly talented Kevin McDonald, our director, you know, he was really basically stringing along a series of dramatic twists and turns that were just building and building and building and building. And the tension in the film he's made is, I think, wonderful.
Yeah. And also, I mean, it feels so sort of claustrophobic. And I mean, as soon as it was finished, when I went outside and had sort of fresh air, I was sort of, thank God for that.
I made it.
Yeah, but was that something, did that inform the performances? I mean, because it looks like you were all in quite close proximity on set. And did you get a sense for that kind of, that claustrophobia and that kind of
Well,
tension?
First of all, it was important that we did, because that's very much the heart of the script. And, you know, the submarine movie is very much a genre in its own right. And along with the impending danger that we talked about, there's also this sense of drama and proximity, because as a storyteller, all you've got are the people in the environment. It's not like you can't have great sunsets or, you know, running horses or anything. You're in a sub, that's all you've got, are characters and how they respond differently to each other and to dramatic scenarios. And Kevin made a great decision, which was to shoot, find and film on a real submarine, and he wanted to be in the room with us so that there was no sense of stepping outside and looking in, that you were in this claustrophobic, you're in the mix. And of course that added immensely. And I mean, luckily we were a really happy and equally, evenly kind of balanced group. I mean, there was a little bit of lunacy. We all went a bit stir crazy towards the end of the shoot. There was a lot of singing to try and keep ourselves sane. But our own little taste of what it must be like was the harsh reality that every day we were in the same tiny enclosed spaces together, and you got to get on in those environments.
I mean, sort of personally, if I picked up a script and the character being offered was called Captain Robinson, I think I'd say yes without a second's thought.
That's what I did.
And I was wondering, what's your favourite ever character name of a role that you've played?
Gigolo Joe's a pretty good name.
That's pretty good. It's not bad. I still quite like Dom Hemingway as a name. I had a good flow to it.
Dom Hemingway, I know. Yeah, it did.
But, and also, I mean, I'm going to sort of, there's a few sort of rumours flying around, so I'm going to annoy you by asking about it now, but there's Knights of the Round Table.
Yeah, that's just a rumour.
That is just a rumour. And Sherlock Holmes 3? Any truth?
Well, there's
in
certainly a will and a desire to make a third. We've got to come back and claim the crown off all these other spin-offs that have, you know, been riding on our coattails for the last few years. The good news is Holmes and Watson worked together into their old age, so there's no real pressure. I think recently it's been more an issue of trying to get the script right. I know obviously Downey's been busy, Guy's been busy, I've been busy. There's definitely a will, and if there's a will, there must be a way.
Brilliant. Well, fingers crossed.
Yeah, I agree. Fingers crossed here too.
Great. Well, thank you so much for your time today. Much
pleasure. Nice to see you.
Yeah, you too.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Hey You Guys!
Hey You Guys, huh?
Hey You Guys,
is that from The Goonies?
It is indeed, yes.
Nice.
Hey You Guys!